Hello everyone, this is a free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. This is problem number 19, practice test 6, section 3, no calculator. This is a grid-in question, and this problem may appear harder than average, for some people, but really it's just about the setup. If you set this problem up correctly, you will not have any problems solving it successfully. Okay, so let's read this. How many liters of a 25% saline solution must be added to 3 liters of a 10% saline solution to obtain a 15% saline solution? Okay, so let's go step by step. So they're saying how many liters of must be added to 3 liters, right? So 3 liters of a 10% saline solution is the original, is the initial number, is the initial volume of a solution, right? So the number of liters of a 10% solution is 3. Okay? So and I'm not talking about the volume of saline itself. I'm talking about the solution itself, right? Everything together. It's 3 liters, right? 3 liters. Now, the initial number of liters of saline in the solution is 3 times 0.1. Right? Because it says 10% saline solution. Okay, so 10% by volume. So 10% means 10% of 3 is going to be 3 multiplied by 10 divided by 100. And 10 divided by 100 is the same as 1 over 10. And 1 over 10 is 0.1. Okay? So the initial number of liters of saline is 3 times 0.1. That's the number of liters of saline itself. Okay? Not the solution, but the saline itself. Then add X liters of a 25% saline solution. Okay? So you're going to add X liters, not the saline itself, but the solution, the mixed solution that has 25% saline by volume. Okay? So you're going to add 0.25 X liters of saline, of actual saline, right? Because it says 25% saline solution will be added. Okay? So X is the solution itself that includes saline, at 25% saline, and 0.25 X liters is the saline itself, okay? Is the actual volume of saline added. So 0.25 X, because 25% of X is 0.25 X, right? 25 divided by 100 is 0.25, okay? And now the new solution will have 3 plus X liters, right? Because we added X liters of a solution, and it's going to be 3 plus X, the final solution, okay? Now, the number of actual liters of saline in the new solution will be 0.15 times 3 plus X, right? Because it says we need to produce a 15% saline solution. So the actual volume of the saline, of the resulting saline in this solution, in the new solution, will be 0.15 times 3 plus X. Because 15%, as usual, is 15 divided by 100, right? So 0.15, okay? So now, all you have to do, you see, if you got this set up correctly, if you got these three important things done correctly, this one, volume of saline itself, the added volume of saline, and the initial volume of saline. If you got these three pieces correctly, you will solve this successfully, because all you have to do, you have to set the sum of the initial and added liters of saline equal to the final number of liters of saline. Okay, so this is the initial 3.0.1, the initial liters of saline, plus 0.25x. This is the added volume of saline, and that equals the final volume of saline in the new solution. Okay, these three things that I talked about. Now, all you have to do is just solve for x, because x is what you're looking for, right? The number of liters of the solution added. X, remember, X doesn't represent the number of liters of saline itself. It talks about the entire solution that's being added that contains 25% saline by volume. All right? So X is what you're looking for. All right? So you're going to solve for X here. So 3 times 0.1 is 0.3 plus 0.25X is equal to And you're going to distribute this correctly. You're going to have 0.15 times 3 is 0.45. You should not have to use this calculator. I know you might say, oh, why is it a no calculator section? Well, you have to know how to do this, because if you know how to manipulate decimals, you know that it's just going to be 0.45, right? The decimal place stays the same. Just imagine you're multiplying 50 by 3, you get 45, and you keep the decimal in its place, two decimals to the left of the final digit here. So it's going to be 0.45 plus, and distribute this, 0.15x. All right. Now, what are you going to subtract, and from where? Well, look for higher numbers. The higher numbers will remain there, and the smaller numbers will be drawn to them. Right. So how does that work? Well, 0.25x is the highest one compared to 0.15x. Right. So you're going to subtract this guy from this guy. Right. So subtract on both sides 0.15. And 0.25 minus 0.15 is going to be 0.1, right? So 0.1x is equal to, and now let's compare the numbers, right? The constants. Which one is greater? 0.45, right? So you have to subtract the smaller one from the greater one. So subtract 0.3 on both sides. You're going to get 0.45 minus 0.3. You shouldn't really have to use paper here, because you know that you can just subtract the 3 tenths from 4 tenths, and you're going to get 15 hundredths. All right? 15 hundredths. Right? So it's going to be 0.1x is equal to 0.15. Right? You divide both sides by 0.1, and really you don't have to worry about that. You don't have to worry about dealing with these things. Just imagine that 0.1 is 1 over 10, right? So 1 over 10 means that you will multiply both sides by 10 to get x by itself, right? So, and when you multiply this guy by 10, because whatever you do on the left side, you have to do on the right. So you're going to get, what happens to the decimal when you multiply this guy by 10? This guy will move to the right, right? Because you're making things bigger. It's not going to go to the left, because obviously multiplying by 10 makes things bigger. So it's going to be 1.5. The decimal moves one digit to the right. One decimal place, right? So now 1.5. Remember, to get 1.5 can be also expressed as a fraction, 3 over 2. If you're not sure how to find the fraction, simply multiply this guy by 2. 1.5 by 2 is 3. So you know that 1.5 must be 3 over 2. Okay?